Hey, this is JR, aka The Tourist. I've just arrived in Bangkok, and I'm about to have what for many people who visit here would be a typical Thai meal. We've got green curry, we've got pad Thai, we've got fried rice. This food is all great, and if you stuck to eating this kind of food for your whole trip, you'd be fine. But I think you'd be missing out on some of the elements that make Thai food really great. Stick with me, I'll show you what I mean.
Come to Bangkok and you'll find something delicious at every turn. On the street, in restaurants, at food courts, this is one of the world's great culinary destinations. I'm not here to tell you what not to eat, or to try to critique the authenticity of this or that dish. Rather, I just want to offer a few suggestions to those who want to up their Thai food game. So let's take a trip around Bangkok and see what we find. The first stop is a few minutes north of the Victory Monument BTS station.
You may know the Thai Thailand National Day. You may also know that there's a controversy behind it. So that's either here or there. Way down. Either a restaurant called Boat in the Valley or a collection of restaurants, a place called Boat in the Valley. It's not 100% sure. It doesn't matter.
There are a lot of noodle dishes I could recommend in place of pad Thai. There's pad siu and drunken noodles, both stir-fried dishes made with flat rice noodles. There's rat nao, which is rice noodles in a thick, gravy-like sauce. There are a lot of options, but I'm going with boat noodles. The small bowls of rice, noodles, thickened broth, and meat, usually pork or beef. Boat noodles encapsulate a bit of history, as Bangkok was once a city of canals. Lone vendors slung soup from their boats, using small bowls to make the handover easier. Over time, the city expanded and roads replaced canals. Even at Bangkok's floating markets, you're more likely to find vendors selling pad Thai from their boats. But places like Ban Kwe Tia Ratan are keeping the boat noodle tradition alive. Though no longer sold from boats, the bowls are still small. You'll want several.
It's interesting. The broth is sweet. It's really sweet. It's almost too sweet, but there's all these other flavors going on. The Chinese spices, the heat from the chilies, a bit of umami from the fish sauce, sourness from whatever. There's all these other flavors that you don't even notice the sweetness. I got Tom Yum noodles as well as the boat noodles. I'm trying those now. I'm kind of wishing I'd eaten these first because it's a more delicate flavor and my mouth is overwhelmed, pause, from the flavor of the boat noodles. It's good.
So if you're going to try everything, start with the Tom Yum flavors, as they're the most delicate. Next time I'll have to try the dry versions, and maybe try one of the other restaurants as well. Next up, let's talk Krapow. We started with noodles, so I guess we do rice next. That makes sense. If you know me, you know that I'm all about doing what makes sense. Trust me, pad Krapow makes sense. You can make the argument that this is the real national dish of Thailand. It's everywhere in Bangkok. But since I'm staying in Lower Sukhumvit, I chose Krapow Tepeh, located a couple of blocks north of Sukhumvit Road between Sukhumvit Soys 21 and 23. There's nothing wrong with fried rice, even when it's served in that goofy pineapple. Fried rice is one of the world's great foods. Part of what makes great fried rice is the wok, the way the high heat caramelizes and chars the ingredients. Pad Krapow is a dish with the same general idea, except in this case, it's not the rice that gets all that wok hay. Pad Krapow literally translates as stir-fried holy basil, and while you can get it with a number of meats, it really is about the basil, which gives the dish an aromatic boost. I'm going with the ground pork, which is the standard version. Pad Krapow is a simple dish in that basil and meat are cooked in a mixture of soy sauce, oyster sauce, and fish sauce, along with garlic and chilies. As I mentioned, you can find Pad Krapow everywhere in Bangkok. But really good Krapow has a couple of things that can really elevate the dish. One is the egg served on top. In many places, the eggs are cooked beforehand to allow for quicker service. But when the egg is made to order, you get this runny yolk that breaks into the dish, just making it that much richer. The other is the way a really hot wok caramelizes the meat, making it crispy but not at all dry. When you get a spoonful of the meat, the egg, the basil, it's really one of the world's perfect bites. For the next stop, let's head west to Chinatown, to a nondescript curry stall that's been in operation for 70 years. The fact that Thai food is so delicious creates a problem. Curries are a perfect example. Meat and vegetables seasoned well and simmered in coconut milk. It's pretty hard to mess that up.
Khao Gang or curry stalls are ubiquitous in Bangkok, and I've just eaten at one of the better known ones, Jek Poo Curry. This place is pretty approachable. They've got a big sign with the menu with the dishes on it, so you can look at the sign and see what it is. You can just look and point as well. They do a lot of sit-down service, but it's just an alley with some stools in it. But they also do takeaway. You see the little plastic bags that people come and take curry away.
Even when it's not seasoned very well, it's likely to be palatable. Maybe you've gotten dragged to some hippie vegan cafe where Moonbeam served you some suspect veggie curry, watery elements cooked to different consistencies thrown over some brown rice. That doesn't sound very good, but go to the wrong spot and that veggie curry might be the best thing on the menu.
If you come to Bangkok, definitely don't sleep on these Khao Gang, these curry stalls. You're going to find some of the best curry, and you may discover some additional dishes as well. For this next dish, we're going to skip the substitution stick and just eat something really delicious, and that's the Thai oyster omelet. Also comes mussels.
The oyster omelet, like beef noodle soup or chicken rice, is Chinese in origin and has counterparts in other parts of the Chinese diaspora. You can find oyster omelets in the Fujian and Chaoshan regions of southern China, where it originated, and in Taiwan, Malaysia, and Singapore, where the Chinese diaspora brought it. In Thailand, the oyster omelet is known as khoi tat, and it's just as often served with mussels, a cheaper alternative to oysters. The oysters and mussels are mixed into a batter of egg and starch, usually tapioca or sweet potato starch, and then fried on the same kind of large pan used to make pad thai. Khoi tat restaurants often serve very good pad thai. You can find two different kinds of khoi tat, varying by the amount of egg in the batter. One kind has more egg and is fluffier, while the other with less egg is thinner and crispier. I went to Hoi Tat Chow Lei and tried both. Hoi Tat are served with this chili sauce that's a bit like sriracha. I've had oyster omelets in China, Taiwan, Malaysia, and Singapore. It's one of my favorite dishes, and the Thai version is one of my favorite varieties. As with all the other basic Thai dishes, there's nothing wrong with mango sticky rice. Especially not when you get it from a place like Mae Vee, which is right down the block from Hoi Tat Choi Lei. But this is a video about expanding your tastes, so we've got to talk about desserts. And for those with a Western palate, dessert in Asia can be a little tricky.
Of all the Thai desserts I've seen and tried, I have two favorites. One is roti, which is a crispy, flaky pancake that's kind of fried on this griddle. They sell them everywhere on the street. Oftentimes they've got banana and egg inside, and they sprinkle condensed milk and maybe some other stuff on the side. You can get cinnamon, Nutella, whatever, all sorts of stuff. The other thing that I really like are these coconut milk pancakes. I don't know what they're called. I'll figure it out and put it up on the screen. But essentially it's a coconut milk batter that's poured into these round grill molds, and this is what comes out. Very good. It's crispy on the outside, and you know what? I never really like when people describe how food tastes, so you're going to have to come to Bangkok and try it yourself. And do that. Come to Bangkok, try the food yourself, stretch yourself a little bit. There's nothing wrong with eating pad thai, but look, if you're willing to move outside of your comfort zone just a little bit, I think what you'll find you'll really enjoy. Thanks for watching.